Is it a good one?
Oh yeah.
It is a good one.
That's a good one. Look at him pull. Oh boy. That's a nice crappie. Oh boy. I might be able to swing him here. I'm gonna swing him right to the camera here. Let's take a look. Oh boy. Now that's why we came to Indiana. We are at the lake. About 9 a.m. in Indiana, just outside of West Baden. And Rustic Collier for these big whites, Monroe Reservoir. We're gonna fish Patoka as well, but Monroe Reservoir on this trip, gonna catch some big white slabs, throw in the bait in heavier brush. The water's up like huge, 7 to 10 feet of water. Throw it in there, single rod, and hunt them down. Let's go get them. Now you say that it's flooded. How high is it compared to normal pool or?
Well, we've had a record amount of rain this spring, and it's right now it's around 18 feet above summer pool.
Wow, so you're just going by history and the spots you know that really find these crappie?
Right, the little channels, little feeder ditches that come in off of the main channel back into these flooded bays, they travel, you know, to come in to spawn.
Yes.
So.
And we're gonna, the average size fish you'd say here, you can probably find some good ones too.
Well, you know, you've got a lot of the small fish, the 6 to 9 inch fish, but then there's the 3 pound fish and over here
three
too.
3 pound. Know, for me, that's like 7 pound bass, my friend.
Yeah.
We're just gonna target cast, right? Hunt them down? Right.
We're just gonna flip jigs and into the face of this flooded brush and hopefully we can hook into some big fish.
Sounds good to me. Let's get at it. Look at this stuff. Look how flooded it is way back there. You all know how crappie can hide. They can be way back or right here.
Yeah.
Like you say.
Yeah, that can be.
One thing about that light line too, you can see it pop sometimes, eh?
It's 14 feet right here.
Eh? Yeah.
It's normally nothing.
Wow.
You can.
I can feel a little of that brush down there. There we go. Oh, I missed a fish right on top there. Rustic, see that? I'm doing the old smallmouth hook set. Did he pop that hard? How did I miss that? Oh Lordy. See that? The first pop and I miss it. I felt all the way to my fingertip. But you see there's other, what other fish are in here?
There's. You've got walleye in here. Both bass, catfish.
Wow, wipers. No. Okay. So we have a variety of species today, couldn't we?
Good.
Yeah, this is really hunting them down. This is neat. I like this. Anticipation of the bite.
So much, many places they can be.
Yes.
You know.
And sometimes we all know they school up so tight. Mm-hmm. There's one. Well, that's a good one.
Is it a good one?
Oh, yeah.
It is a good one.
That's a good one. Look at them pull. Oh, boy. That's a nice crappie. Oh boy, I might be able to swing him here. I'm gonna swing him right to the camera here. Let's take a look. Oh boy, now that's why we came to Indiana. Nice man, eh? Look where he got it too. That's a lucky shot because it came through in by the front of the lip. But that's one for the camera, one for the live well for some pictures. A nice little thick backs on them too. Handsome little fish. Now, would you say that's eggs or is that just from eating?
That's eggs.
Eggs. Okay. We're gonna let her go, but you know what? We're gonna try to get some real big ones. Where should I put this girl? Right up in here? Okay, beautiful. Let's do that. Look at that. She's with her little friend. Come on, you in there. And hunting them down, man. It's fun. I was just swimming that thing. You're saying there's all brush down here. The water's like 14 feet higher, so they could be almost anywhere. But again, tree, swam it out in front. And just the weights there. No tick, just the weight. Lean back. You saw what happened. Let's keep doing it. This is great. That's fun, man. That was a good way to start. Whew. Where's your great big mama here? Putting it out like that, letting it fall. I'm counting about 3 or 4 seconds. Not even, like you see the brush. And just lift and drop real slow. Missed one right there. And just keeping that up in that strike zone, I think. They see it. Lower it a bit when I get brave to put it in the brush. And then lift it again. And I keep throwing it right here, just in case there's big mama or a friend of Big Mama hanging around. Come on, you big crappie. Now, do you think that's probably the most popular species that people chase in Indiana is a crappie?
Oh, most definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's fun for everybody.
Yes.
Kids and everybody enjoys it, you know.
Swimming the grubs, yeah. Nick, most people, how they fish, the same way? Or is it float? Oh,
that's
good
a big
one. It's a big one?
I think so. Nice. Yeah, it's a big one.
Oh.
Well, bigger. I mean, bigger than
the other one. Oh, nice, nice. Oh, that's real nice. Almost the same spot, wasn't it? Oh, nice fish.
That is a nice,
nice
fish.
One. Wow.
It is a nice fish.
Oh, yes. Very nice, sir. Like I say, we can put some in the box for some pictures and then let them go after. Very nice fish. Looks like she was hanging out with the other one, eh?
Yeah, they just move in, you know?
Yeah.
Hit this and hit this. And then, you know, 30 minutes and maybe two swim in here and bam, bam.
Gotcha. You got that one with the little Roadrunner?
Yeah.
Nice. So normally you can just pinpoint your brush pile or whatever it is you're looking for.
Right. See now with all the newly flooded land and timber, they're just scattered all over, you know. And
yes.
Makes it a little more difficult to find, but
yeah.
But they still travel their same little routes, you know, into yep. their spawning grounds and try to concentrate on that, you know, and
gotcha.
Those main areas.
Gotcha. All right, we'll keep at it. Let's do it.
If it goes down.
Better one?
A little bit. No.
That's eater almost, isn't it?
Yeah, it's an eater.
There's the eating size. The biggest thing is, see all this brush like this? It's all thick. It's all over the place. You gotta pay attention. You know, don't just make long bomb casts and just hope there's a fish there. You gotta put it in, close the bail, and watch your line and your rod. You lower your rod tip sometimes as the jig is just falling like that. And I'm watching the line. It's so imperative. A little bit of a cold front, and those fish aren't just slamming it, they're almost melting it. So sometimes the line goes slack, sometimes it punches up, sometimes it just moves to left or right, lean back on the fish. It's imperative to pay attention. Get way more of those crappie bites into the boat.
There you go. Bigger.
Oh, yeah,
big
fish.
One, big one.
Yep.
Big fish.
Real good one there. Look at that.
Need an
oh, boy.
That?
I might need it. Russ, I think he inhaled it good. Oh, yeah, look at him twisting and turning. Oh, yeah. Indiana white slab. And there you are. Oh, boy. Just feel the difference, eh? That little bit of... And that's a result right there. See that? That's what we came for right here, man. Nice little trip down West Baden, Indiana, catching slabs. And the temperature's been killer for us. Just dropping all day. What'd you have last week, Russ? 80 degrees?
Oh, yeah. 87 one day.
Wow. Well, we're going to put a few more in the live well for some pictures. So far, so good. You know what? I just don't feel the cold that much when I get bit, but you gotta soldier on, man. Catching whites. Let's do it. Fun fish. Go on in there. Again, rest on the Roadrunner, getting them on that too. Slab hammer, put it right inside. Lifted it, dropped, lift, weight. There it was. Let's keep at it. So best time of year, you think, to come down here.
Oh, well, it's usually, you know, I would probably say about the first full moon in April would be a good way to kind of try to plan a trip on. You know, and even in late March, and some of them days that warm up, you know, up into the 70s or 60s, you know, sometimes we can get into some big fish then.
I should keep me alive on that, more on the spots. Good one?
Bigger.
Oh, that's a good
bigger.
One. Yeah, yeah.
It's not real big, but it's bigger.
That's a good one. A netter or a swinger?
I don't know. I can't tell. It ain't real big. It's pretty nice, though. mean, it's better than normal. Better than the little ones.
Yeah. Look at the mouth on that thing. She thinks she's a bass. Oh, yeah. That's a nice little crappie, Russ. Fun to catch.
Pretty.
Fun to eat, too, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Sitting by the willow. Look at that. Something to eat, something to take pictures of.
There might be a big one there, though.
Yeah, beautiful. Yeah. I'm going to try that little roadrunner I got there, too. I like that little swimming action. This, I seem to put this little slab hammer and real heavier stuff in the brush and swim in it, but something about that little roadrunner, boy, you can cover some water.
You know, you won't catch as many as a little fish, but if there's a big one there, he's gonna slam, she's gonna slam it.
Nice.
You know,
I like that. Yeah. That's a good way to fish. I like that theory. Big fish, a little bit bigger bait. Hey.
Uh-oh.
Good
Uh-oh,
one?
Big one.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Uh-oh. Nice. Well, no, it ain't. It's not a real big one.
A netter?
No.
No?
It's a nice
scooper.
Fish. It's a little bigger than normal, but it is.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Nice one. Nice fish. Ooh, Russ, real good. That's a nice fish. Boy. No matter where you fish, that looks good, doesn't it? Boy.
Today, I think anything looks good.
Yeah, with this cold.
Yeah, this cold front coming in.
Right here, whatever. You gotta put it right on their faces, eh? Big ol' slabs.
Oh.
Some weight.
Yeah, it's hard to tell on that brush.
Yes. There it goes. Oh, that's a good one.
Really? Yep.
Oh, yeah.
That's a bigger one.
That's a bigger one. Look at that. Just swimming it. And he thumped it. That's a difference in the bite. Boy, oh, boy. Just swinging him up right to you, bud. There he is. Right through the lip again. Look at that. Just swimming the little slab hammer. You know, right away, a bit more weight to him. A little bit more back. No bragger, but a good eater. Someone in your family is going to thank you for that one, isn't it? Aren't they? Look at that. Good eater. Look at those. There's some nice ones in there. Take some pictures of some of those. We're just covering a little bit of water here. Just, you can tell it's all brushed, all flooded. You can waste a lot of time fishing in one little area with nothing. Covering a little roadrunner, a little slab hammer, grub. You can swim that grub. You start finding things that are holding some more fish, you can fish them more vertically. But for right now, horizontal approach is a winning approach. And there we go. A few more back. Russ gonna keep some for dinner there. In our sink. Come on, turn around. And look at that. Indiana wants me. Bring me back now. There you go.